So we saw that if we asked these three questions, well, we needed three questions to be sure that we would find the gold star by opening one box. But we don't need three questions. If we're a little smarter about our questions, we only need two. And the way to do it in two questions is to ask a question that gives us more information. So the problem with asking the "is it in the green box" question first is that 3/4 of the time, the answer is no. And if we're trying to use yes-no questions, or we're trying to use bits to get as much information as possible, what we want to do is ask questions where the answer is equally likely to be yes as it is to be no. We want a question where half the time the answer is yes and half the time the answer is no. If the question isn't like that, so if it's a question where the answer is no more often than it's yes, well, then we could guess the answer is no and be right more than half the time. So we're not getting a full bit of information in the result because we had a good chance of being right without getting that answer. So we want to figure out questions where the answer is equally likely to be yes as it is to be no. So we could ask that as our first question. So we're going to ask, is the gold star in either the green or the purple box? So the answer is yes if it's in one of those two boxes. The answer is no if it's in either the blue or the red box. So there are 4 boxes. For 2 of the boxes, the answer is going to be yes. So half the time, the answer is yes. So that means we're gaining one full bit of information. If the answer is yes, we've learned that it's in either the green or the purple box. If the answer is no, we've learned that it's in either the blue or the red box. And so if the answer is yes, well, now we need to ask one more question to figure out which box it's in. And that could be, is it in the green box? And so if we ask that question, if the answer is yes, well, then we know it's in the green box. If the answer is no, then we know it's in the purple box. We only needed 2 questions to get to the right box. And that's the same if the answer was no to this. Well, then we can ask, is it in the blue box? That's a yes-no question. If the answer is yes, well, then we know it's in the blue box. If the answer is no, then we know that it's in the red box. So now we can cover all 4 possible boxes. We didn't need 3 questions like we did when we asked, is it in the green box? Is it in the purple box? Is it in the blue box? We might have needed 3 questions to determine the box. Here we only needed 2.